mentions. Srimati Santa Chhetri, please late. Just read the title.
Sir,
read the title.
I request you to allow me to mention the following matter of urgent public importance in this house.
Just read permitted. The title and
yes.
Late.
Sir, my subject is non-appointment of judges affect speedy
okay.
Justice.
Okay.
Timely delivery okay. Of justice is a part
okay,
of human
Santa
right.
Ji. It's okay, it has been late. You just read the title, it's complete. Sri A.K. Selav Raj, just read the title and late.
Okay. My special mention is environmental clearance for road development in the resort forest area. Thank you, sir.
Sri Rakesh Sinha. Just lay Rakesh Ji, sirsak padde.
Chaar line to padde.
Sirsak padde.
माइग्रेंट लेबर की समस्या दिनों-दिन बढ़ती जा रही है 2017 के आर्थिक सर्वेक्षण के अनुसार 2011 से 2016 के बीच में 9 मिलियन प्रतिवर्ष माइग्रेशन एक राशि
लेकर दे राकेश लेकर
थोड़ा इस समस्या पर तो बोल दे सर
फिर
ये हासिए के लोग
राकेश जी प्लीज लेकर दीजिए
अच्छा इसका निष्कर्ष मैं पढ़ दे रहा हूं सर
नहीं आप लेकर दीजिए सिर्फ लेकर
तो मैं तीन पंक्तियां मैं बोलना चाहता हूं इसे सारांश के रूप में एक तो माइग्रेंट लेबर्स को वोटिंग राइट नहीं वोट नहीं दे पाते हैं दूसरा उनके कॉन्ट्रैक्टर्स
एक्सप्लॉइट करते हैं जाता है
एजुकेशन की सुविधा नहीं मिलती है
प्लीज सर आप लेकर
माइग्रेंट लेबर की समस्या दिनों-दिन बढ़ती जा रही है 2017 के आर्थिक सर्वेक्षण के अनुसार 2011 से 16 के बीच में 9 मिलियन प्रतिवर्ष माइग्रेशन एक राज्य से दूसरे राज्य में हुआ 2001 की जनगणना में माइग्रेंट वर्कर्स की कुल संख्या 314 मिलियन थी जो 2011 में बढ़कर 453.6 मिलियन हो गई 1991 से 2001 के बीच में माइग्रेशन 35.5% की दर से बढ़ गई 2001 से 2011 के बीच में 44.2% हो गया इससे यूपी बिहार मध्य प्रदेश पंजाब राजस्थान की संख्या सबसे अधिक है इनमें महिलाएं और बच्चों की बड़ी संख्या है और उनकी माइग्रेंट लेबर में गिनती भी नहीं होती है इनकी पहली समस्या स्वास्थ्य की है महिलाएं प्रायः एनीमिया की शिकार रहती हैं दूसरी समस्या बच्चों की शिक्षा की है स्थान बदलने के कारण बच्चों का स्कूलों में नामांकन नहीं हो पाता है होता है तब ड्रॉप आउट अधिक होता है तीसरी समस्या और भी चिंताजनक है इनमें से अधिकांश चुनावों में चाहे स्थानीय निकाय का हो या राज्य विधानसभा का हो या लोकसभा का मतदान नहीं कर पाते हैं चौथी समस्या निजी ठेकेदारों द्वारा उचित मजदूरी नहीं देने की है बीमारी या किसी आपदा की स्थिति में इन्हें सहायता या मुआवजा भी नहीं मिल पाता है बड़े मंजिलों और सड़कों पुलों का बनाने वालों के अस्थायी आवास जानवरों से भी बदतर होती है छत्तीसगढ़ झारखंड से आदिवासी बच्चियों का बड़े पैमाने पर दिल्ली मुंबई लाया जाता है वे घरों में काम करती हैं उनका रजिस्ट्रेशन तक नहीं होता है ना ही उचित मजदूरी मिलती है अतः सरकार से अनुरोध है कि इन समस्याओं को सुलझाने के लिए तत्काल उचित कदम उठाए धन्यवाद
धन्यवाद शांता छेत्री जी आप भी पढ़ें आपको
भी सर माय सब्जेक्ट इज नॉन अपॉइंटमेंट ऑफ जजेस इफेक्ट स्पीडी जस्टिस सर Timely delivery of justice is a part of human rights. Denial of speedy justice is a threat to the public confidence in the administration of justice. May I state in this august house that 39% of the sanctioned strength of the judges of the high courts are lying vacant as on 1st June 2019. Sir, the fundamental rights of the citizen under Article 14, 19 and 21 of the Constitution have been violated by denying them the right to speedy justice due to non-appointment of judges in courts. I would like to remind the Honorable Law Minister that judiciary is the part of basic structure of Constitution and also considered to be a pillar of democracy. Sir, democracy is the lamp of judiciary is the lamp of the democracy. Sir, right to speedy trial is considered as a fundamental right which has been explicitly dealt in Hushyanara Khatun case and this right is implicit in Article 14 and 21. It is of the utmost necessity that present situation may be addressed and meaningful direction may be issued for the interest of justice in a larger public interest. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Mr. A.K. Selvaraj.
The PMG USA is being implemented in the ratio of central 60 and state party. The PMG USA is not able to implement in reserve forest area where the tribal communities are living because of delay in environmental clearance. The existing roads in the tribal people living area in forest are in very bad shape and need to be developed under PMG USA. Both the state and central government are ready to bear this chair up for market for making the existing road in forest areas as paka roads, but due to lack of environmental clearance the work could not be carried out in forest area across the country, especially in the Karamadai block, which comes under the district of Coimbatore in Tamil Nadu, that is Nellithurai to Pillur and Tholambalayam road to Moonukuttai via Arakkadavu, similar road in other blocks such as Perinakkambalayam, Thondamuthur in Coimbatore district should also be developed as paka roads under PMGSI. In the absence of paka road in the tribal living forest areas, the tribal peoples are facing hardship for transportation and for getting instant medical care. The children of tribal people have to walk a long path reaching schools as a vehicular movement on the existing roads is impossible. The elephant attacks on human beings in these areas are high and even results in loss of life. Therefore, I urge upon the government to give environmental clearance for development of roads in reserve forest areas in the country so that these roads can be made as paka roads under PMGSI with chair of both central and state. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Sri Amar Patnaik.
Thank you, sir. So, admittedly, left-wing extremism is a grave internal security threat to the integrity of the nation. Even though law and order is a state subject, Naxalism is not. At one time, it had spread across 60 districts in 5 states of the country, taking toll of hundreds of lives, besides impeding development efforts in some of the remotest and poorest regions in the states. My state, Orissa, has also suffered the brunt of Naxalism since decades. 18 out of 30 districts were once under the influence of Naxal terror, even though it has substantially reduced now due to the proactive action of the state government. Whatever success has been achieved in tackling this problem has been possible only due to the combined effort of both the center and the states. The center has deployed paramilitary forces to supplement the state effort. Besides, this issue cannot be treated as a mere law and order issue. It includes developmental deficit in these districts for which the center had earlier framed the IAP and BRGF, which have, however, been closed now. Despite the above facts, letters are being received from center regularly for recovery of the cost of deployment of these forces from the states. Honorable Chief Minister of Orissa has repeatedly requested the center to waive off this amount. It is therefore requested that this expenditure may be met from central resources and the cost of deployment incurred by the state so far, which runs to about 34,655 crores as on 1/10/2017, of which Orissa has rupees 2,907 crore, Jharkhand has 6,778 crores, and Chhattisgarh has 9,082 crores, be completely waived off. Thank you, sir.
Sri Sambit Patra. Sasmit Patra.
Yeah, thank you. Honorable Deputy Chairman, sir. The special mention subject is about omission of Odisha from list of 17 iconic tourism sites to be developed by Government of India. Odisha is the land of arts, culture, heritage, biodiversity, scenic beauty, and breathtaking tourist sites, which is globally acclaimed and acknowledged. For centuries, Odisha's architecture, seen today in Konark Sun Temple or the biodiverse Chilika Lake have mesmerized tourists. The richness of the Diamond Triangle Buddhist circuit in Odisha has been a beacon of peace and forgiveness for the world. The crocodiles of Bhitarkanika National Park or the tigers of Simlipal National Park are memories that bonds a family of tourists for a lifetime after leaving Odisha. Despite such iconic tourist sites being present in Odisha, it comes as a surprise and shock that not even one of the five tourist sites mentioned by me is considered worthy by the Union government to be listed among the 17 iconic tourist sites to be developed by the Union government. In the recent Union budget 2019-20, the Union Finance Minister referred to the development of 17 iconic tourist sites, but Odisha has been completely omitted. Honorable Chief Minister of Odisha has written to the Union government on 10th July 2019 for inclusion of at least two tourist sites in Odisha from among Konark Sun Temple, Bhitarkanika National Park, Chilika Lake, Simlipal National Park, and Diamond Triangle Buddhist Circuit in the list of 17 iconic tourist sites to be developed by the Union government. Sir, 13% of the state's revenue comes from tourism, and I strongly demand that the Union government include at least two from among the five tourist spots mentioned in their 17 sites. Thank you.
Thank you. To associate Sri Prashanna Acharya ji.
President, lay the test of my matter as well.
Sri K.C. Ramurthy. Sri Amar Sankar Samle. आप ले करेंगे या पढ़ेंगे
पढ़ेंगे
ले कर दे तो अच्छा है
पिछले बार भी ले किया धन्यवाद माननीय मैं आपके माध्यम से यह कहना चाहता हूं कि देश की राजधानी दिल्ली के साथ-साथ देश के अन्य भागों में प्रदूषण की स्थिति चिंताजनक बनी हुई है परिणाम स्वरूप बच्चों का कद घट रहा है और उनका स्वास्थ्य भी प्रभावित हो रहा है यह रिसर्च पेपर आईआईटी दिल्ली के सेंटर फॉर एटमॉस्फेरिक साइंस में एक एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर ने अपने कुछ सहयोगी के साथ की है इस अनुसंधान के अनुसार गांव के बच्चों की बच्चों को दोहरी मार झेलनी पड़ रही है आंकड़ों के अनुसार गांवों में कुपोषण और स्वास्थ्य के कारणों से कमजोर हो रहे बच्चों पर प्रदूषण की मार शहरी बच्चों के मुकाबले ज़्यादा पड़ रही है प्रदूषण के कारण बच्चों की ऊँचाई हर जगह प्रभावित हो रही है चाहे वह गांव हो या शहर विशेष तौर से नवंबर से जनवरी के बीच पैदा होने वाले बच्चे अधिक प्रभावित है क्योंकि इस दौरान प्रदूषण अधिक होता है मैं अध्यक्ष महोदय आपके माध्यम से सरकार से अनुरोध करूंगा कि बच्चों के विकास व स्वास्थ्य के लिए प्रदूषण पर काबू पाने का उपाय करें क्योंकि आज का बच्चा कल का देश का भविष्य है स्वस्थ बच्चे स्वस्थ भारत धन्यवाद
श्री संजय सेठ एब्सेंट श्री मोतीलाल बोरा एब्सेंट डॉक्टर संजय सिंह एब्सेंट श्री अश्विनी वैष्णव
थैंक यू सर द सब्जेक्ट ऑफ माय स्पेशल मेंशन इज डिग्निटी ऑफ एम्प्लॉयज ऑफ मीडिया चैनल्स सर आई वुड लाइक टू ड्रॉ योर काइंड अटेंशन टू द राइट्स ऑफ मीडिया एम्प्लॉयज सर Employees and senior executives of a media channel have publicly shared their distress over three matters. First matter is mistreatment of women employees, including use of foul language, deployment of muscle men, and threats to their safety. Second, employees and executives have sought public attention towards non-payment of salaries and wages, sir. Third, employees have expressed shock over hire and fire policy adopted by their management, sir. Sir, is this not a matter of public importance that requires the urgent attention of this House? Doesn't our Constitution provide protection to people working in media, sir? Isn't there a role of this House and government in providing, in protecting the dignity of media personnel? Sir, through you, I humbly request this House to take note of importance of protecting freedom of expression and request government to take necessary steps for ensuring freedom of media and dignity of media personnel. Thank you, sir.
Sri Muhammad Nadimul Haq, Muhammad Nadimul Haq, not present. The House stands adjourned till 11 hours on Friday, 19th July 2019.